it is finally finished, and I think it turned out really awesome.
I'm Bill.
I'm Kelley.
And this is our
adventures.
Oh. Here we go.
Well, this whole camper project, I've been doing it over the last month or so. I swear, here in Alabama, I feel like we go through multiple seasons in 1 month. We've had winter.
Can you say that? Oh my gosh, so cold.
We had spring.
And I'm sorry if I sound horrible. Everything's blooming and all the pollen's coming out and my sinuses are like all blocked up.
And now it's winter. Again. Welcome to Alabama, where you can have all four seasons in 1 month. I hope y'all have really enjoyed seeing this transform from our bedroom that I had remodeled when we first moved into the camper to now. When we first moved into the camper, I was just putting up peel and stick wallpaper and doing a few little things, but I really went all out, or I feel like I went all out and changed way more on the camper, and I really made this our own space. I don't know if you know or noticed or not, from the last video to this video, I moved the lights. I had them strung up out here, and I thought they were really cute, but that hole was kind of dark. And you can turn on the lights that we installed, but they're really bright. And I wanted like a romantic space for me and Bill to hang out in. So I ended up putting them in there. Also, thank you to one of my subscribers. I swear I looked at it. I was looking at it on my phone. The reason the blinds are tilted down is because I put the bracket on upside down. So just so you know, the bracket works upside down. It just makes them tilted. And I probably will go and flip it around so they go back right. I just don't have time right now because my parents are coming in town next week. And I've got to finish the bathroom organization and remodel a little bit of it before they come in town. And I've got to clean up the camper because doing projects, things pile up everywhere, so I've got to finish that. And the reason that I have to get the camper ready is because they're coming down here to stay for a few weeks, so we're taking our fifth wheel up to an RV park about 15-20 miles from here for them to stay because we don't have full hookups here at our house. I don't know what the weather and stuff would be like, so we're gonna let them have a mini vacation, and they're excited about doing that. So I don't have time to flip them around right now, but I will. It's not going to be that hard. It's just aggravating that I put them in backwards. See, like, I guess I was talking not to the camera and not paying attention to the instructions. So I wanted to show, like, a few things that I've done in this space. First off, we put up the rocking wood behind the bed in the actual slide out, which turned out well beyond my expectations. It is beautiful. Absolutely love that wood that I put that up. I put up the blinds that I've installed the bracket backwards, but it still works. But I'm gonna do it. And I ended up, originally I had them a lot lower because I wasn't sure where I was gonna put the shelves. And I didn't even know what shelves I was gonna put. But after the things were tilted, I decided to move them up, and I'm glad that I did. I really, really like them better up higher. You know, you're supposed to go with curtains to the ceiling around your windows. I guess you should do that on blinds too, because I wasn't thinking correctly. Because they looked really funny low. I got two shelves at Hobby Lobby. I painted the metal part black because it was like a kind of like a rust brown color, and I wanted black So I did that. And then it's got the perfect place for Bill to put his coffee cup up there. It sits there, but yet I still have my pretty decor up that I put up with the museum putty so that I don't have to mess with it while travel day. Installed the cute lights, the reading lights. Those were more for decorative purposes. I mean, we might turn them on every once in a while if we need to see something, but that's what I wanted them to look like. And they can turn around and you can adjust them. And they were actually made for RVs. I bought them off of Amazon and it had the switch on them and everything. Now, we did run into a problem. The hole underneath the light that was there, there was no way for Bill to attach it. So we had to come up with like a little a plate to cover the hole and then put the light onto that. And I think it looks kind of cool because it kind of matches all my wood stuff too. I also, to brighten up the space, instead of painting, because I wanted to try not to do any like major like painting or anything, but I wanted to brighten up the space around the mirrors. I love my mirrors. I know I see people all the time on Facebook talking about they'd hate them, but I love mine. I use mine a lot. So I wanted to keep the mirrors, but brighten up this space. So I've added these curtains on a rod, and you could do them on a tension rod. I just did like a regular rod, but you can move them around and everything. As far as the bedding goes, I used the queen bedding that I had, the queen bedspread that I had, and then this bedspread is out of the house and I bought a new one for there. I made the two pillows that have the bears and stuff on them. I thought they turned out really cute. And then I already had this pillow, and then I added the heart to tie in with the blue pillows that I have on the back. Also, a big problem that I have incurred with doing this remodel and keeping up the bed with the mattress on top of it to go into the storage area, Bill has messed with it and tried to see if he could figure out why, and he just feels like it's the mattress is too heavy. So I don't get in there all the time, and I'm just gonna get like a stick to hold it up when I'm kneading up under it. And then, because the only time I get in it is when we got like people stay in here, because I have like all the blow up mattresses, and I have like blankets and pillows and all that extra stuff stays up under there. So it's not like I open it up very much. I'm in love with the space. I'm in love with the blinds that I made. I think it turned out great. This remodel is finished. I hope you enjoyed it, and I will show you some B-roll of this beautiful space. Welcome to all our new subscribers. Till next time, like and subscribe.